Hello folks, thank you for joining today. I'm very excited to talk to you about Dekorate, a tool for generating Kubernetes manifests. Based on this agenda, I will try to give you an introduction to Dekorate and demonstrate how it can be used in order to generate Kubernetes manifests for Java-based applications. I will finish talking about some other Dekorate features and what's coming in the future. My name is Aurea and I've been working for the Red Hat Sprint team for a year and a half now. In the team, we try to provide the best experience to Sprint users that want to take their applications and deploy them on Kubernetes or OpenShift, the Red Hat Kubernetes distribution. Let's start talking a little bit about the cloud native landscape. As you may know, the development and deployment of applications has significantly changed during the last few years due to the adoption of the cloud as infrastructure. And we have also changed the architecture of applications from monolithic to microservice. With more and more companies moving to Kubernetes, it's becoming the standard way of running such distributed applications. What do we need to deploy an application on Kubernetes? To deploy an application on Kubernetes, we need to create some objects called Kubernetes resources. These objects will allow the platform to install our application. Kubernetes follows a declarative model, meaning that the user defines the desired state of the application and the platform will make the appropriate modifications in order to match this state. These Kubernetes resources are described in so-called Kubernetes manifests as JSON and YAML files, and we create them by posting such manifests to the Kubernetes REST API endpoint. In this slide, we can see an example of Kubernetes manifest in YAML format, which contains two Kubernetes resources. The creation of this manifest in form of YAML and JSON files can be tedious due to the complexity of the object format and also due to the numerous fields to be manipulated. Let's see how Dekorate can help us on this task. So, what's Dekorate? Dekorate is a collection of tools for creating Kubernetes and OpenShift manifest. With Dekorate, developers don't need to edit any XML, JSON, or YAML to customize this manifest because Dekorate will do it for us. It will automatically generate the manifest during the compilation of the application, as easy as adding a jar into the class path. Dekorate does support vanilla Kubernetes and Red Hat OpenShift. But what are the strengths of Dekorate? Dekorate works for all build tools and all JVM languages. In Spring community, languages like Kotlin or Groovy or tools like Gradle are really taking off, so it's very important for us to include all those. Dekorate allows fine-grained customization. Developers can customize manifests using annotations, properties, or both of them. They don't need to edit any JSON or YAML files. Dekorate can be used also as a library, not just a standalone tool. So, for example, Quarkus Kubernetes extension family is using it to generate the Kubernetes manifest. And finally, one of the most important goals of Dekorate is to provide the simplest out-of-the-box experience. So it's able to detect Java frameworks like Spring Boot, Quarkus, And it's able to align the generated manifest accordingly. For example, if you are using Spring Boot, Dekorate will detect it and will add automatically a port to the generated deployment. I like to represent the steps to perform with Dekorate as a pipeline. So the first thing to do is add the jar to the class path in order to enable Dekorate, configure in different values if we want to customize the manifest, then generate the manifest by compiling the application, and after that we should to build and publish the container image to an external image registry in order to allow the platform to run it. And finally, we can to apply the manifest to the target cluster. It may sound a little bit bold, so I would like to make a demo to show you how it works. So I'm going to open my terminal and I'm going to make the demo using a Spring Boot application that I'm going to generate from the Spring initializer site. I open my editor and it's a simple Spring Boot application based on Maven, and I'm going to perform some modifications in order to show the basics of Dekorate and how it works. So I have my project, I have a POM file. So the simplest user experience shouldn't invoke requirements neither on any external tools nor plugins, just adding a single jar to the compilation class path will do the job. It will trigger and bootstrap the generation process. So that's the first thing that I will do. I edit my POM file and I'm going to add a dependency to the list of dependencies. In order to enable Dekorate, I will choose Kubernetes Spring Starter because I have a Kubernetes cluster and Spring application. Now I open my terminal and I'm going to compile my application with Maven clean package. Once I compile my project, I will see that Dekorate will automatically generate a new folder under target directory, classes, metainf, Dekorate, which contains two files. These are the JSON flavor and the YAML flavor of my manifest. The manifest itself is pretty simple. It contains a deployment resource pointing to a container image that I'm going to use and a couple of recommended labels. Now I would like to add some code to my application. I'm going to go to the source folder and I'm going to add a Spring REST controller. It's a very simple Spring REST controller that will print hello world when a request will be sent. And this time, by compiling the project again, Dekorate will detect the presence of the REST controller annotation, and realize that we're talking about a web application and will expose automatically the HTTP port to the outside world in form of Kubernetes service. So if we open the manifest, this time I have a service resource binded to the 8080 port. At this point, let's configure more decorates in order to customize the manifest. Initially, Dekorate provides two configuration interfaces in order to customize manifest. If we choose to do it with annotations, we are going to use things like Kubernetes application, where we can perform very fine-grained customization with things like labels, envars, and so on. And I'm going to set the number of replicas to 3. Launch the compilation again, and if everything goes well, I should have the number of replicas reflected here in the manifest. So yes, I have 3 replicas, but still there are people that just prefer use properties. Dekorate provides the ability to do the same configurations using properties. I just have to add to open application properties file and put here my configuration. So I change the value intentionally in order to see that it will be reflected in the manifest, and I will add a few more properties. Dekorate Kubernetes Expose in order to expose my application outside the cluster, and Dekorate Kubernetes host, which is the host under which my service will be available. SB demo, and I'm using the NIP service. So I'm done. I finish. I can compile my application in order to customize the manifest. If everything goes well, I will have a new ingress resource generating because I have exposed my application. Well, the replicas is 4 because the value in the application properties has a higher priority. And an ingress resource to expose my application outside the cluster with the host that I have configured. To sum up, Dekorate will configure manifests giving higher priority to the properties configuration. Okay, so far I have generated the Kubernetes manifest pointing to a container image, but this container image does not exist yet. We need to build it and to publish it to an external resource in order to allow Kubernetes to run it. To do so, I have 2 possibilities. I can do it without Dekorate by using a container image tool like Docker, for example, and after that I will be able to deploy the manifest with kubectl apply command. And the other possibility is to use the hooks provided by Dekorate to trigger the container image build and push, and even Dekorate provides a hook to perform the apply of the manifest at the end of the compilation process. So I'm going to use these hooks. I just need to configure the container image build strategy for Dekorate. Dekorate does support Docker and JIP as container image build strategies. In this case, for this demo, I will use JIP because it allows to completely avoid having to write a Docker file, so it's very useful, but you can use also Docker. For make Dekorate to use JIP as container image build, we need to edit the POM and add a new dependency. The dependency is jib annotations. So now I'm ready. I can trigger the manifest generation, the container image build and push, and the deployment of the manifest in one single step, adding some flags to the compilation command. Let's see what is the... It is the Maven Clean package, and we add some flags in order to trigger these other additional steps. Dekorate build for building the image, Dekorate push through for passing the image to an external registry, and Dekorate deploy in order to apply the manifest at the end to the target cluster. So let's trigger the process. And here in the console, in the terminal, we will able to see that the image, you can see that the image is going to be built with JIP, and also it's going to be pushed to the Docker Hub registry, because it's the registry where I'm logged in, so it's using docker.io in order to push the image. Okay, so it's finished. It's finished. It means that my application has been deployed to the Kubernetes cluster. So I'm going, if everything goes well, if I get the host and access to it in a browser, I should see hello world. Let's get back to the slide. So here a little slide to recapitulate the steps done and the commands. And let's talk about other Dekorate features. What about serverless? Dekorate does support Knative by generating and Knative serving service, and also by providing a wide range of configuration options for tuning Knative things. What about continuous delivery and continuous integration? Dekorate does support Tekton. It's one of the features recently added. Using Dekorate Tekton module, users can get automatically a pipeline that includes steps like the compilation of the application and also the build and push of the container image. For observability, Dekorate does provide support for things like Prometheus or Jagger, regardless whether you're using their operators or not. It also provides light integration with frameworks like Spring, as just demonstrated, Thorntail, Quarkus. Even Micronauts has recently added Dekorate as feature. And last but not least, Dekorate can be used also without framework. Before closing this presentation, I would like to present one more features to come. It's in our scope to include the support and extend the operator coverage for operators like KeyCloak operator, KubeDB, and one of my colleagues is currently working on service binding operator implementation. If you want to learn more about Dekorate, even contribute to the project or communicate with the team, I let you hear some resources: the GitHub repository, the complete configuration guide, and plenty of examples to discover the power of this fantastic tool. Thank you very much.